Temple Grandin, she is autistic and she has a lot of autistic issues, sensory issues and socialization issues, all that stuff. But she's absolutely just completely understands animal behavior in this crazy way where nobody else can see it, but she can absolutely see it. And she designed ways that we can, and you know, all the vegans and the vegetarians are going to hate this, but she designed ways that animals could go to slaughter and be at peace because they're moving in a natural way. You see all those horror videos of cattle and pigs and stuff squealing and chickens freaking out and they're butchering other chickens in front of chickens. And I mean, there's a lot of horrible right. videos out there. And I'm not pushing an agenda either way of vegetarianism or meat eating. I'm just bringing forward that she has this ability. And while she employed it in that way, she's employed it in other ways as well. But that was a need that those types of animal farmers needed. And so she rose to the challenge because, again, she didn't make it mean anything that we were taking animals to slaughter and we eat those for food. She was seeing a need that was arising and she had a very specialized skill of mastery to meet that. And if we would stop treating those people like garbage and discriminating against them and allow them, when they get hyper-focused like that, to go down that path, we would end up with a society.
Gosh, the efficiency, I'm just thinking.
I know.
Well, like we'd have all these specialists, and not everybody's going to be fully specialized. There's going to be people who are, you know, implementing and stuff too. But just having that to guide us, right? Just be like, wow, how much faster would we evolve?